اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سبحانك يا الله تعاليت يا رحمن، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا رحيم تعاليت يا كريم، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا ملك تعاليت يا مالك، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا قدوس تعاليت يا سلام، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا مؤمن تعاليت يا مهيمن، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا عزيز تعاليت يا جبار، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا متكبر تعاليت يا متجبر، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا خالق تعاليت يا بارئ، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا مصور تعاليت يا مقدر، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا هادي تعاليت يا باقي، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا وهاب تعاليت يا تواب، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا فتاح تعاليت يا مرتاح، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا سيدي تعاليت يا مولى، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا قريب تعاليت يا رقيب، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا مبدع تعاليت يا معيد، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا حميد تعاليت يا مجيد، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا قديم تعاليت يا عظيم، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا غفور تعاليت يا شكور، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا شاهد تعاليت يا شهيد، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا حنان تعاليت يا منان، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا باعث تعاليت يا وارث، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا محيي تعاليت يا مميت، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا شفيق تعاليت يا رفيق، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا عنيس تعاليت يا معنس، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا جليل تعاليت يا جميل، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا خبير تعاليت يا بصير، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا حفيظ تعاليت يا مليع، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا معبود تعاليت يا موجود، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا غفار تعاليت يا قهار أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا مذكور تعاليت يا مشكور أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا جواد تعاليت يا معاد أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا جمال تعاليت يا جلال أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا سابق تعاليت يا رازق أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا صادق تعاليت يا فالق أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا سميع تعاليت يا سريع أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا رفيع تعاليت يا بديع أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا فعال تعاليت يا متعال أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا قاضي تعاليت يا راضي أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا قاهر تعاليت يا طاهر أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا عالم تعاليت يا حاكم أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا دائم تعاليت يا قائم أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا عاصم تعاليت يا قاسم أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا غني تعاليت يا مغني أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا وفي تعاليت يا قوي أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا قافي تعاليت يا شافي أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا مقدم تعاليت يا مؤخر أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا أول تعاليت يا آخر أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا ظاهر تعاليت يا باطن أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا رجاع تعاليت يا مرتجى أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا ذا المن تعاليت يا ذا الطول أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا حي تعاليت يا قيوم أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا واحد تعاليت يا عهد أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا سيد تعاليت يا سمد أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا قدير تعاليت يا كبير أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا والي تعاليت يا متعالي أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا علي تعاليت يا أعلى أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا ولي تعاليت يا مولى أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا ضريع تعاليت يا باريع أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا خافض تعاليت يا رافع أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا مقسط تعاليت يا جامع أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا معز تعاليت يا مذل، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا حافظ تعاليت يا حفيظ، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا قادر تعاليت يا مقتدر، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا عليم تعاليت يا حليم، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا حكم تعاليت يا حكيم، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا معطي تعاليت يا مانع، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا ضار تعاليت يا نافع، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا مجيب تعاليت يا حسيب، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا عادل تعاليت يا فاسل، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا لطيف تعاليت يا شريف، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا رب تعاليت يا حق، أجرنا من النار يا مجيد. سبحانك يا ماجد تعاليت يا واحد، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا عفو تعاليت يا منتقم، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا واسع تعاليت يا موسع، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا رؤوف تعاليت يا عتوف، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا فرد تعاليت يا وتر، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا مقيت تعاليت يا محيط، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا وقيل تعاليت يا عدل، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا مبين تعاليت يا متين، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا بر تعاليت يا ودود، أجرنا من النار يا مجيد. سبحانك يا رشيد تعاليت يا مرشد، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا نور تعاليت يا منور، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا نسير تعاليت يا ناصر، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا صبور تعاليت يا صابر، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا محسي تعاليت يا منشيع، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا سبحان تعاليت يا ديان، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا مغيث تعاليت يا غياث، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا فاتر تعاليت يا حاذر، أجرنا من النار يا مجير. سبحانك يا ذا العز والجمال، تباركت يا ذا الجبروت والجلال. سبحانك لا إله إلا أنت، سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. فاستجبنا له ونجيناه من الغم، وكذلك ننجي المؤمنين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله أجمعين، والحمد لله رب العالمين، وحسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا علي يا عظيم يا غفور يا رحيم، أنت الرب العظيم الذي ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. وهذا الشهر عظمته وكرمته وشرفته وفضلته على الشهور، وهو الشهر الذي فرضت صيامه عليه، وهو الشهر رمضان الذي أنزلت فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان، وجعلت في ليلة القدر وجعلتها خيرا من ألف شهر. فيا ذا المن ولا يمن عليك، من علي بفكاك رقبتي من النار في من تمن علي، وأدخلني الجنة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم أدخل على أهل القبور السرور، اللهم أغني كل فقير، اللهم أشفي كل فجائع، اللهم اكس كل أريان، اللهم اقضي دين كل مدين، اللهم فرج عن كل مكروب، اللهم رد كل غريب، اللهم فك كل أسير، اللهم أصلح كل فاسد من أمور المسلمين، اللهم اشفي كل مريض، اللهم سد فقرنا بغناك، اللهم غير سوء حالنا بحسن حالك، اللهم اقضي عنا الدين وأغرنا من الفقر، إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم رب شهر رمضان الذي أنزلت فيه القرآن وافترضت على عبادك فيه الصيام، صل على محمد وآل محمد، وارزقني حج بيتك الحرام في عام هذا وفي كل عام، واغفر لي تلك الذنوب الإثام فإنه لا يغفرها غيرك يا رحمن يا علام.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم إني أفتتح الثناء بحمدك، وأنت مسدد للثواب بمنك، وأيقنت أنك أنت أرحم الراحمين في موضع العفو والرحمة، وأشد المعاقبين في موضع النكال والنقمة، وعظم المتجبرين في موضع الكبرياء والعظمة. اللهم أذنت لي في دعائك ومسألتك، فاسمع يا سميع مدحتي، واجب يا رحيم دعوتي، وقل يا غفور أثرتي. فكم يا إله من قربة قد فرجتها، وهموم قد كشفتها، وعثرة قد أقلتها، ورحمة قد نشرتها، وحلقة بلاء قد فككتها. الحمد لله الذي لم يتخذ صاحبة ولا ولدا، ولم يكن له شريك في الملك، ولم يكن له ولي من الذل، وكبره تكبيرا. الحمد لله بجميع محامده كلها، على جميع نعمه كلها. الحمد لله لا مضاد له في ملكه، ولا منازع له في أمره. الحمد لله الذي لا شريك له في خلقه، ولا شبيه له في عظمته. الحمد لله الفاشي في الخلق أمره وحمده، الطاهر بالكرم مجده، الباسط بالجود يدا، الذي لا تنقص خزائنه، ولا تزيده كثرة العطاء إلا جودا وكرما، إنه هو العزيز الوهاب. اللهم إني أسألك قليلا من كثير، مع حاجة بي إليه عظيم، وغناك عنه قديم، وهو عندي كثير، وهو عليك سهل يسير. اللهم إنا عفوك عن ذنبي، وتجاوزك عن خطيئتي، وصفحك عن ظلمي، وسترك على قبيح عملي، وحلمك عن كثير جرمي، عندما كان من خطئي وعمدي. أطمعني في أن أسألك ما لا أستوجبه منك، الذي رزقتني من رحمتك، وأريتني من قدرتك، وعرفتني من إجابتك، فصرت أدعوك آمنا، وأسألك مستعنسا، لا خائفا ولا وجلا، مضلا عليك فيما قصدت فيه إليك. فإن أبطأ عني عطبت بجهلي عليك، ولعل الذي أبطأ عني هو خير لي لعلمك بآقبة الأمور. فلم أر مولا كريما أصبر على عبد لئين منك علي. يا ربي إنك تدعوني فولي عنك، وتتحببوا إلي وأتبغضوا إليك، وتتوددوا إلي فلا أقبل منك، كأن لي التطول عليك. فلم يمنعك ذلك من الرحمة لي والإحسان إلي، والتفضل علي بجودك وكرمك. فارحم عبدك الجاهل، وجد علي بفضل إحسانك، إنك جواد كريم. الحمد لله مالك الملك، مجري الفلك، مسخر الرياح، فالق الإسباح، ديان الدين، رب العالمين. الحمد لله على حلمه بعد علمه، والحمد لله على عفوه بعد قدرته، والحمد لله على طول أناته في غضبه، وهو قادر على ما يريد. الحمد لله خالق الخلق، باسط الرزق، فالق الإسباح، ذي الجلال والإكرام والفضل والإنعام، الذي بعد فلا يرى، وقرب فشهد النجوى، تبارك وتعالى. الحمد لله الذي ليس له منازع يعادله، ولا شبيه يشاكله، ولا ظهير يعادله، قهر بعزته الأعزاء، وتوادعا لعظمته العظماء، فبلغ بقدرته ما يشاء. الحمد لله الذي يجيبني حين أنادي، ويستر علي كل أورة وأنا أعصي، ويعظم نعمة علي فلا أجازي. فكم من موهبة هنيئة قد أعطاني، وعظيمة مخوفة قد كفاني، وبهجة مولقة قد أراني، فأثني عليه حامدا وذكر حوم مسبحا. الحمد لله الذي لا يهتك هجابه ولا يغلق بابه ولا يرد السائله ولا يقيب آمله. الحمد لله الذي يؤمن الخائفين وينجي الصالحين ويرفع المستضعفين ويدعى المستكبرين ويهلك ملوكا ويستخلف آخرين. والحمد لله قاسم الجبارين مبير الظالمين مدرك الهاربين نكال الظالمين صريخ المستصرخين موعدي حاجات الطالبين معتمد المؤمنين. الحمد لله الذي من خشيته ترعد السماء وسكانها وترجف الأرض وعمارها وتموج البحار ومن يسبح في غمراتها. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. الحمد لله الذي يخلق ولم يخلق ويرزق ولا يرزق ويطعم ولا يطعم ويميت الأحياء ويحيي الموتى وهو حي لا يموت بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير. اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك وأمينك وصفيك وحبيبك وخيرتك من خلقك وحافظ سرك ومبلغ رسالاتك أفضل وأحسن وأجمل وأكمل وأزكى وأما وأطيب وأطهر وأسنى وأكثر ما صليت وباركت وترحمت وتحننت وسلمت على عهد من عبادك وأنبيائك ورسلك وصفوتك وأهل الكرامة عليك من خلقك. اللهم وصل على علي أمير المؤمنين ووسي رسول رب العالمين عبدك ووليك وأخي رسولك وحجتك على خلقك وآيتك الكبرى والنبأ العظيم، وصل على صديقة الطاهرة فاطمة الزهراء سيدة النساء العالمين، وصل على سبتي الرحمة وإمامي الهدى الحسن والحسين سيدي شباب أهل الجنة، وصل على أئمة المسلمين علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي. والخلف الهادي المهدي هججك على عبادك وأمنائك في بلادك صلاة كثيرة دائما. اللهم وصل على ولي أمير القائم المؤمل والعذل المنتظر وحفه بملائكتك المقربين وأيده بروح القدس يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعله الداعي إلى كتابك والقائم بدينك استخلف في الأرض كما استخلفت الذي من قبله، مكن له دين الذي ارتديته له، أبدل له من بعد خوف أمنا يعبدك لا يشرك بك شيئا. اللهم عززه وعزز به وانصره وانتصر به وانصره نصرا عزيزا وافتح له فتحا يسيرا واجعل له من لدنك سلطانا نسيرا. اللهم أظهر به دينك وسنة نبيك حتى لا يستخفي بشيء من الحق مخافة أحد من الخلق. اللهم إنا نرغب بك في دولة كريمة تعز بها الإسلام وأهله وتذل بها النفاق وأهله وتجعلنا فيها من الدعاة إلى طاعتك والقادة إلى سبيلك وترزقنا بها كرامة الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم ما عرفتنا من الحق فهملنا وما قصرنا عنه فبلغنا. اللهم المن به شعثنا واشعب به صدعنا وارتق به فتقنا وكثر به قلتنا وعزز به ذلتنا واغن به عائلنا واقذ به أن مغرمنا واجبر به فقرنا وسد به قلتنا ويسر به عسرنا وبيض به وجوهنا وفك به أسرنا وأنجح به طلبتنا وأنجز به مواعيدنا واستجب به دعوتنا واعتنا به سؤلنا وبلغنا به من الدنيا والآخرة آمالنا واعتنا به فوق رغبتنا يا خير المسؤولين وأوسع المعتين اشف به صدورنا وأذهب به غيظ قلوبنا واهدنا به لما اختلف فيه من الحق بإذنك إنك تهدي من تشاء إلى صراط مستقيم وانصرنا به على عدوك وعدونا إله الحق آمين. اللهم إنا نشكو إليك فقد نبينا صلواتك عليه وآله وغيبة ولينا وكثرة العددنا عدونا وقلة العددنا وشدة الفتن بنا وتظاهر الزمان علينا فصل على محمد وآله وأعنا على ذلك بفتح منك تعجله وبذر تكشفه ونسر تعزه وسلطان حق تظهره ورحمة منك تجللناها وعافية منك تلبسناها برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم برحمتك في الصالحين فأدخلنا وفي عليين فارفعنا وبكأس من معين من عين سلسبيل فاسقنا ومن الحور العين برحمتك فزوجنا ومن الولدان مخلدين كأنهم لؤلؤ مكنون فأخدمنا ومن ثمار الجنة والهوم الطير فأطعمنا ومن ثياب السند والحرير والأستبرق فألبسنا وليلة القدر وحج بيتك الحرام وقتلا في سبيلك فوفق لنا وصالح الدعاء والمسألة فاستجب لنا وإذا جمعت الأولين والآخرين يوم القيامة فارحمنا وبراءة من النار فاكتب لنا وفي جهنم فلا تغل لنا وفي عذابك وهوانك فلا تبتلنا ومن الزكوم والذريع فلا تطعمنا ومع الشياطين فلا تجعلنا وفي النار على وجوهنا فلا تكببنا ومن ثياب النار وسرابيل القطران فلا تلبسنا ومن كل سوء يا لا إله إلا أنت بحق لا إله إلا أنت فنجنا. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم إني أسألك أن تجعل فيما تقضي وتقدر من الأمر المحتوم في الأمر الحكيم من القضاء الذي لا يرد ولا يبدل أن تكتبني من حجاج بيتك الحرام المبرور حجهم المشكور سعيهم المغفور ذنوبهم المكفر عن سيئاتهم وأن تجعل فيما تقضي وتقدر أن تطيل عمري في خير وعافية وتوسع في رزقي وتجعلني ممن تنتشر به لدينك ولا تستبدل بي غيري. أعوذ بجلال وجهك الكريم أن ينقضي عنه شهر رمضان أو يطلع الفجر من الليلة هذه ولك قبل تبعة أو ذنب تعذبني علي. الله
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر. ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. صدق الله العلي العظيم.
رحم الله من يقرأ الفاتحة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بفضل بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين حبيب إله العالمين أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
طب القلوب ودوائها ونور أبصارها وعلى أهل بيته الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. يقول الله عز وجل في كتابه الكريم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. هو الذي خلقكم من تراب ثم من نطفة ثم من علقة ثم يخرجكم طفلا ثم لتبلغوا أشدكم ثم لتكونوا شيوخا ومنكم من يتوفى من قبل ولتبلغوا أجلا مسمى ولعلكم تشكرون. آمنا بالله. صدق الله العلي العظيم. صلوات
اللهم صل على محمد.
ولتبلغوا أجلا مسمى ولعلكم تعقلون. مؤمنين المؤمنات, once again we give thanks to Almighty Allah تبارك وتعالى for gracing us with this wonderful opportunity in this beautiful and holy month of Ramadan. The verse I've just quoted is a very powerful verse, mu'minin and mu'minat. I made a mistake, that's why I recited the last part. It's Quran 40, verse 67. If you examine this verse, mu'minin and mu'minat, you realize that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala highlights on the three main stages of our lives. Each and every one of us in this world, before we depart from this world, our lives are of three important stages. The first stage is childhood stage. So look at the ayah. Allah begins, هو الذي خلقكم من تراب. He is the one who created you from the dust. ثم من نطفة. Then from the liquid. ثم من علاقة. علاقة is clot. Then from there he said, ثم يخرجكم طفلا. Then he removes you as a child. So that's the first stage, childhood stage. The second stage, ثم لتبلغوا أشدكم. Then you reach your maturity, your strength, meaning youthful stage. Then the last one, ثم لتكونوا شيوخا. Then you become old. That's the last stage. So these are very critical and important stages of our lives. Now, departing from this beautiful ayah, I know we don't have much time, it's a bit late starting. Our topic of tonight is tackling disintegration between young and old generations. This is a very important topic, meaning and more not. Our examination is of the following brief stages, very brief. First stage is to quickly highlight on embryonic stage of our lives. Because this embryonic stage of our lives lead to childhood stage. Second stage of the examination is then to focus on the youthful stage, marhalatu shababiyya. And then the last stage is then to share some practical tips on how to bridge gaps between the young and old generations. It's a challenge we face globally on how to bridge gaps between the young and the old generations. And so it's important we learn from the Holy Quran and the teachings of our beloved Prophet and Ahlul Bayt. So kindly, I humbly seek your indulgence. First stage, as I said, quick highlight on embryonic stage of our life. It is called Marhalatul Janiniya. At one stage, we were embryos. Then that goes through different transformations until a moment when our moms gave birth to us. So what is embryonic stage? Mu'minin and mu'minat. Embryonic stage is a stage where our minds and our witness, mean to become smart, and our style of doing things in life is shaped. It's a very important stage of our lives. When a mom conceives, it's so powerful. And this embryonic stage, mu'minin and mu'minat, it is of six levels. I'll not be able to discuss the six levels because it's not really the point I would like to put across tonight. But it's something, if you have time, you can go through it yourselves. Six levels. Each level is important. Where do we get the levels from? Quran 23, verses 12, 13, and 14. The verses will be on the screen. Powerful. So we look at the ayah. Allah says, وَلَكَدْ خَلَكْنَا لِإِنسَانَ مِنْ سُلَالَةٍ مِنْ طِينٍ. Indeed, we created insan from an extract of clay. That's fine. Clay what? Meaning food. Because food grow on earth. And to understand this beautifully, the first word of a child is the loins of the father. Hence, scholars say, upbringing of a child is 50% before birth and 50% after birth. Very important discussion. Wallahi. Sometimes we look at challenges, we don't look at it from the root. We're trying to solve it from there. That's why we all struggle. What is 50% before birth? Who is going to be the mother of your children? Who is going to be the father of your children? It's all part of 50% before birth. What's the background of the one who is going to be the mother of your children? What's the background of the father to be for your children? All constitute 50% before birth. So when Allah says thin, extract of clay, meaning what? What father eats is what makes the liquid. And this liquid makes a child. Father's mindset, father's inclination is so important. That alone can affect the growth of a child. So first, children are here. That's one. But this extract of clay is not the first level. The first level of embryonic stage is nutfa, the liquid. Where is the liquid coming from? Food. Where? Father. And then father will then transfer it to mom. So important. If your life is full of a halal, what you're going to transfer will be unbelievable. If life is not full of halal, then, Habibi, it's going to be a challenge. If your mouth doesn't know kind words, it affects. So you can think about it. So nutfa is the first level. Now from there, it's going to be with our moms, mothers. For 9 months, for 6 months, depending. 7 months. So the mindset of a mom is crucial. What she does is so important. What she eats is crucial. And Quran says, وَأُولَاتُ حَمْلٍ فَأَنْفِكُوا عَلَيْهِنَّ حَتَّى يَضَعْنَ حَمْلَهُنْ. That those women who are expecting, provide, feed, of course lawfully, until they give birth. So there's going to be a lot of transformation within a mother. Her mood is crucial. Where she goes is important. What she sees is important. What she hears is important. The people she interacts with, crucial. for the child. Allah is in the process of making the child. That's why you remember, family, wallahi, is so important, mu'minin and mu'mina. We will not be struggling too much in our mosque if families are, mashallah, on, if most of them are on the right track. So liquid. After liquid, it's obviously a piece of cloth. A piece of solid blood. And the second one, and you'll see it's mentioned there. The third one is lump of flesh. Fourth one, bones. Fifth one, flesh. And the last one is what? ثُمَّ أَنْشَأْنَاهُ خَلْقًا آخر. Then we give him, or we initiate him for another life. That's when soul comes. Some scholars said after 8 weeks. There are so many discussions. As I said, I don't want to go too much into that. So 50% before birth, 50% after birth. Second stage of the examination. Youthful stage. That's actually the main part of my discussion tonight. Quran says, ثُمَّ لِتَبْلُغُوا أَشُدَّكُمْ. Then you reach your maturity, your strength. This line refers to youthful stage. My dear brothers and sisters, and my fathers and my mothers, the most important stage of life for every individual is youthful stage. Losing that stage, I will not say completely over, but it's not going to be easy. Wallahi. You know what is that stage? It's a stage when masir of insan is determined. When your destiny, how you're going to be, is determined. By who? By you. By your family, by your community. So now question. Who is a youth? That's very important. There are so many definitions of who a youth is. But I found two definitions I would like to share. One is biological definition, and the other one is psychological definition. Biological definition, there are so many variations. But the one I would like to share with is that youth are those between age 13 to 35 or to 40. Youth, that's biological definition. 13 to 35 or to 40. These are youth. Psychological definition is what? This is from one magazine I read of by the name Alamul Ma'rifa of Mahmoud Qidham. That youth is someone who has the power to be productive and creative. You cannot call yourself youth if at this stage of your life you're not productive or creative. That's the most profound definition of youth I came across. So from here, I ask a question. What are the features or the characteristics of youthful stage? So here, elderly persons listen very carefully, and also youth listen very carefully, because I've got a point and message to put across towards the end of my tonight lecture. Inshallah. Youth have some serious and amazing characteristics. Likewise, others, children, they have their amazing characteristics. The first feature of a youth is that, it comes from the definition, youth is productive and creative. Yes, there may be some youth who are not willing, that's something else. But in the general, when you provide platform for the youth, they will surprise you. By nature, they are productive and they are creative. If you want to impose on them everything, then you will inhibit the potential of being productive and creative. Yes, there are some youth, whatever you try, don't worry. They will not budge. But not majority. That's first feature. Second feature of a youth is what? They are quick in taking decisions. Sur'atul karar. Some elders can take 6 months to take just one decision. Maybe in a good way. I'm not saying it's wrong. But the youth is not like that. Youth, when you delay them, they become frustrated and they'll stay away. So sometimes, I'm not talking to just Mombasa, I'm talking to everyone who will listen to me. When you see youth don't come to the programs, don't get worked out. Sit and analyze and ask yourself why. Am I doing the right thing or not? Is the problem me or them? Some will not come. You can bring angel, they will not come. But not majority. They are quick in decision making. So if you delay them, simple thing you want to do, red tape, you will not get them. You will always see the same face. Good number of community, when you go there, you two are active, are the same face. It means there's a problem. So that's two. Number three feature, youth. They are receptive to changes. Elderly persons may not really want any change. They want routine. We've been doing it 100 years. Let's do it. That's how we inherited. But youth are not like that. It is a feature placed in them by Allah. You can make your own research. Don't take what I'm saying just like that. Make your own research. And I'm willing to engage. But make your own research. I'm just giving general guidance. Youth, they've got this potential to accept changes. And they want to see changes from time to time. If you don't do that, Alhamdulillah, big khoshali, everybody will come. That, don't worry about it. Muharram, don't worry. Bring local, mobile, whoever. Don't bring anyone. Everybody will come. So for me, as a resident alim, I don't look at Muharram. I don't, even Ramadan sometimes, I don't look at especially big night. Oh, community is growing. No. Look at normal days. Very normal days. Then you will know whether you are growing or you are falling down. Muharram, mashallah, is full. Don't worry. That is sentimental. It's emotional. People will come. Shahada of Amir al-Mu'minin. If you don't see many people, it's not like they don't want to come. Maybe something beyond their control. But that's normal. So youth, they want changes. Obviously, you as a youth, what is needed is positive change. Some youth may only come, I want change for the sake of changing. It doesn't work out that way. It has to be positive change. And you as an elderly person, Baba, if it is not Sunnah and Quran, change. If it's Sunnah, Quran, then we can't do anything. But if it's not Sunnah and Quran, you've been doing it 20, 40 years, fine, it's good, it's amazing. But what stops you from changing? And I'll give some examples in going forward. So these are some of the features of youth. Now, challenges faced by youths of today. Challenges. Listen to this very carefully. I'm not going to mention all the challenges. I can't. I don't have the knowledge of all the challenges. But I'm going to mention some of the challenges. First, youth of today, because of their exposure to technology, they think they are independent. Yeah? They think they know everything. Educated than the elders. Maybe making some good money than the elders. Or not exposed to the world. So they think they are independent. You as an elderly person, don't become aggressive towards that. The moment you become aggressive towards that, you'll lose that youth. You'll not see them here. You'll come and pray and go. You'll not get them. Note that youth, they feel they are independent. Even this goes to the fathers of youth. If you become aggressive towards them asking you to allow them to run their programs or to become independent, you will lose them. How do you go about doing it? Try to become their friends. The moment they have confidence in you, they will literally share everything with you. Yes, there are some exceptional cases. I'm not talking of exceptions. I'm talking on the general. That's the first challenge. So you as an elderly person, you as a leader of a community, don't become aggressive. I know sometimes it can be too emotional. No, relax. Chill. Try to befriend them. Try to be soft. And you as youth also try to be respectful if you want something. Don't expect things to happen overnight. So that's number one. Understand that if you have youth in your house, you have youth in your community, they all think they are independent because of the exposures they have. Second challenge, this came in one of the questions. Cultures and traditions. It's a challenge. Youth are faced with this challenge. Youth will come and tell you, too much traditionals. It is not for me, Sheikh. It's a Baba come. No, too much, Sheikh. And I'll give you examples. Good number of youth feel, you know what, our communities, they just stick into culture, tradition in some of the programs. As a result, we do not find it relatable. So we're not going to make any efforts. It's a reality. The earlier we wake up to this reality, the better. Before it is too late. Example. Every Thursday night across the globe, Surah Yasin, Dua Ikumail, Majlis, isn't it? There is no ayah of Quran or hadith that says every Thursday, do this in order. But it's good. I love it. Me, as a person, I love it. But sometimes youth will come to you. Habibi, change this for me. Just do Dua Ikumail, small lecture, let's go home. No, some are insisting do Yasin. Of course, Yasin is the heart of the Holy Quran. But this is not hadith from the Prophet or Ahlul Bayt. Every single Thursday, do it in this order. I give an example. I've been somewhere. I said to people, you know what? In Sha'ban, instead of doing Dua Ikumail, sometimes recite munajati Shaaban. Ilash, ilalalalash. I said, Baba, there is no ayah of Quran saying I must continue like this. Yes, Amirul Mu'minin encourage us. Recite dua Kumail every Thursday. But we're just changing. It's another dua of Ahlul Bayt. Otherwise, no, some people will never do this dua until they die. So this is tradition. Because we've been doing it this way, we want to continue doing that way. You're going to lose your youth. Habibi, may I sit on member? It's been quite a good number of years. I interact with youth more than the way I interact with others. If you want to stick to your guns, fine. But you may get less youth. Because they will not feel or have this sense of belonging. So they've got this challenge. You need to help them to understand. And I'll give solutions later on. I'm not just mentioning problems or challenges. I'll give solutions, inshallah. Another example of culture or tradition. Nime Shaban. There is a ziyara maqsus for Imam al-Husayn. No, somebody said, ziyara tawarisa. Other Shias are not doing that. We may be doing that. That's fine. It's excellent. It's powerful ziyara. Without an iota of doubt. But some youth will say, no, why? Let's do that maqsus of Aba Abdullah and go home and make dua. But then you'll find some elders who say, no, some. I'm very careful in choosing my words. Some. No. Come rain, come shine. We have to say, fine, do it. You're going to enjoy, isn't it? That youth, you're losing him. It's crucial. No, youth will say, you know what? The program is too long. Cut it. But you say, no, 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 no. That's how it is fixed. We're not going to do anything about it. So they've got this challenge. It's a challenge. How do you get them appreciating the orders we have? It's so important. There are youth who don't even understand Urdu. It's a reality. One of my favorite are Urdu recitation. Wallah, if you check my phone, you've got more than 100 Urdu recitation. When I'm down, 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 like Moody, Quran and Urdu. Wallahi. But the reality is some youth don't understand. Maulana can come, proper fada'il, fada'il. They don't know what the guy is talking about. It's a challenge. How do we bring them on board? It's a challenge. Number three challenge our youth are faced with. Life challenge. Life challenge. Yes, elders are also going through. But youth, wallahi. May Allah bless our elders, man. Yeah, youth are going through roller coaster. Struggle internally. Some have reached marital age, either no money or proposals are getting turned down every day. I'm talking of both ladies and gents. That stress alone. Some they've graduated, they are looking to establish themselves to be on their feet. That roller coaster challenge is there. It's a challenge they are faced with. So when they come to me and I don't address their issue, or they come to the mosque and we don't address their issue, they will look for it somewhere else. So let's try to understand this and initiate and begin conversation. Don't say, no, it must be this way or that way. Fine, let it be. You lose them. Losing them, meanwhile, they will be here, they will counsel everything, but they will not show any interest. Last but not certainly the least challenge. Youth can waste time. Yeah, they can. With social media, because they are seeking, some of them, instant gratification. On Instagram, TikTok now, is too much. That's where they spend most of their time, some of the youth. So it's a challenge. Now question. How do we bridge gaps? So I'm going to give you a few practical tips and then we're done. So I said I don't want to take too much time. It's late. Number one. So I'm giving you challenges. Number one. Understand their times. Some of our elders, they don't want to understand. Wallahi. It's okay. We are doing it. I'm happy. It's true. I agree. Understand the challenges they are going through. May Allah bless the founders of all the communities across the globe. Those elderly people, without any technology, they brought us far. And they raised most of the elders we see here. The challenges that time was different. Today, because of social media, the world wants our youth. And we also want them. If we are not steps ahead of them, the world will fetch them. Yes. The world wants them. Social media, the world wants them. You also want them. You want to see them in the most packed. As you. So what are you doing to see them? So number one, at-tafahum. Understand their times and their struggles. I'm not saying every youth. Some youth, mashallah, they are nightmare. I agree. Some youth are disobedient. I agree. And they need to wake up. But we need to initiate conversation on how to do that. Don't give up. Don't give up. Elders, don't give up. Sometimes you need to sacrifice a little bit and they will worship you. So how do you understand their times? Understand these two things, mu'mineen and mu'minat. Current generation, their time is called jilu ittisal. Old generation, your time is called jilu tawasul. So you've got ittisal, you've got tawasul. What is ittisal? Information technology. Meaning what? For me to make a friend within a minute, I can make 5-10 friends more than that. In this day and age. Hence, friendship do not last in this day and age. But in the olden days, jilu tawasul is connecting generation. Whereby, apart from your home, is madrasa and the community and the few friends that you have. That's it. That's why personally I feel those times there were a lot of baraka. Today, when your old friend who lives in London comes to Mombasa, you see him, it's as if you've established friendship to that. Just now, came to Tama, Badu Baraba, TK, Alhamdulillah, Suche. You talk to the person, Konche, you want to know more from that person. But today, it's easy, I make friends and I dissolve it overnight. Your generation, my elders, you had unbelievable patience. Today, the way the world is going roller coaster, there is no patience. And our youth are going through that challenge every single day. Some of them don't sleep. They are on their phones throughout the night. Stress. So if our community cannot stop and think and reflect and say, you know what? Let's do something different. You want to go the way you are doing? I'm not talking of only Mombasa. I'm talking of general. Then we're going to have a struggle. And when a challenge rises, we react to those challenges. We need to be proactive and not reactive communities. So understand their times. This is the time of information technology. Some of our elders, excuse me, forgive me, they don't even know what TikTok is all about. Youth are so engrossed in it, Allahu Akbar, and it's just affecting them every day. Instagram, look at it. Because you see, the world wants you, whatever is in your mind, to post it, and you are posting like no one's business. Your time, everything, mashallah, nice. Your father slap you here, you give him this to slap again that time. So, jilu ittisal, jilu tawasul. In trying to understand. There is a second point I want to make to understand the current generation. You know, this current generation, Habibi, they are jil akthar intiqadan. They literally ask everything. They ask the reason for everything. You hold the lash, they ask you, why are we holding lash? When they ask you, don't tell them kafir, you are not, la 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 la. If you don't have an answer, reach out to those who can help to answer them. Don't say no, chokroni, la 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 la. No, I've seen this happening and I'm worried sometimes. They don't know. If they do not ask in the community, where are they going to? They will go on social media and Google, or social media will give them some information. Sometimes simple question like that, why are you doing matam? Some people get worked out. So this jil aktharu intiqadan, they ask, they criticize. You send some of your sons and daughters to go and study uni, and they study critical thinking. So they will come back and throw those questions. The moment, may Allah forbid, you lie to them in answering, or you bash them away, that is the beginning of losing them. The question. If it's me, you, Aina Shida, no problem. Let's continue like this, business as usual, isn't it? But we want to leave behind a legacy. We come replicas of our beloved imams, which is excellent. I love it. It reminds me of Karbala. It reminds me of Najaf al-Ashraf. It reminds me of Abul Fadl al-Abbas. These are excellent. But you two will come. Why? Sheikh, why? Sit. Explain. Have a workshop. Explain. Allow them to talk. That's their nature. I don't know if you deal with YouTube, you understand what I'm talking about. That is their nature. Their attention span is too short. That's why psychologists today in the world, they'll say, when you talk, after every 10, 15 minutes, crack a joke. So you get people back. But some of us, we compare, but when you go to university, 2 hours, the university is different. He knows he's going to get money. But this one, although this is the most important, isn't it? How many will stand, will sit in front of movie for 10 hours? But mosque is different, isn't it? So you need to go, or hasty, pille. So that's, try to understand that. And alhamdulillah, all of our elders across the globe, they are not short of wisdom. You know, the Khoja world, powerful. Anyone who can run a business and thrive is too strong. Use that, because in your businesses, you are becoming creative and productive. But why, when it comes to your communities, you're not becoming creative and productive? You exploring technologies in your businesses, regardless of your age. Why in community, when some ask for that, you say, no, we can't. So youths, they query. They query. So that's first solution. Understand their time. When you understand their time, it can make life easy. Number two solution. Hewar. Dialogue with them. From time to time, community, bring them. Dialogue. Ask them, what do you want? What's the problem? What's the challenge? They don't come, go look for them, bring them. If you don't do some, will end up in drugs. Yes. Don't take things lightly. We need to help them. We, alhamdulillah, we are good. We are established as elders. Our parent, your parent did unbelievable job. I believe they are in the highest level of heaven by building all these communities. Now it is your duties to ensure that you prepare the future generation so that they can continue with your legacies. Dialogue with them. Bring them, invite them, dinner, something, come. Tell me, what was the problem? What do you want from us? What do you want? Don't impose programs on them. Certain programs, nobody can come and say, do this. There are certain programs fixed. But certain programs, we can do something about it. That's second solution. Third solution, they said, when you engage a young adult or youth, show that young adult true love. You know what is true love? Pay maximum attention. Unconditional attention. When they talk to you, don't think, excuse my word, it's rubbish. You will kill their confidence, they will not come back. Maximum attention. Pay to what they say. And last but certainly not the least, solution to bridge gaps. You need to have a very strong youth subcommittee and get dynamic youths to be elected by the youth to run it. Sometimes you can appoint, but when you allow them to choose who they want to lead them as youth, it makes it more easier to bring them on board. So the bottom line, Mu'minin and Mu'minat, I know I cut it short here and there because of time. Youth are going through so many challenges. Wallahi, I'm serious about this. They are going through a lot of challenges. We need to pay attention to some of those challenges. And you as youth also, try to understand circumstances. You cannot be spoon-feeded. You need also to show. That's why Amir al-Mu'minin said the best way to run a community is to have elders who are advisors and youth on the ground to implement. Islam grew through the effort of the youth, isn't it? Prophet said, "Inna Allah ba'athani bil-haqqi bashiran wa nazira." فَحَالَفَنِ الشَّبَابُ وَخَالَفَنِ الشُّيُوخُ He said, Allah sent me as a warner and a carrier of good news. Then the elders disobeyed and the young ones accepted. Elder doesn't mean not ever elder. No, there were some top elders in the camp of the Prophet, Abu Ayyub al-Ansari. When Prophet arrived in Medina, his house was old man. Look at the camp of Aba Abdullah. Majority were youth. But the elders like Habib ibn Madahir al-Asadi, I mentioned last night, like Muslim ibn Awsajah, top. These were people of wisdom. So my elders, I'm not saying you are dying. No. Allah knows who is first. You've got amazing wisdom. Share it before you reach a point where you cannot talk. Share. How you run in your business, share. Before it's too late. Where you'll get a point you cannot share anymore. For instance, Muki, how you've been running for the many, many years. This is the biggest challenge Muki work is to, because you can become the enemy of the Maulanas. But share. Share with people. It's so important. You've got wisdoms. There shouldn't be a community where in a year there is no forum between the elders and the young ones to dialogue. So I leave you with that. Try. And hence I invite you all humbly. Register for Itikaf. Young and old. Attend the Itikaf. That will be a means of breaking the ice. And you know, itikaf, as some asked yesterday, is it only the last 10 nights? No, last 10 nights of Ramadan is definitely recommended. But you can do it during any part of the holy month of Ramadan. Even like in Rajab, we have itikaf. So register our fathers and attend this itikaf and make it a point that you're going to cleanse your soul and become true lover of Allah and take your love for Allah to the next level. If you have time and you can take some break from your busy schedules, register for 3 itikaf. It's during the Easter, yes. Take a break. It's so important. And you will not regret. May Allah forgive us, inshallah. May Allah, the elders who started this community, I am sure every day their commissions are unbelievable from Allah. May Allah elevate their status in Dar al-Akhirah. Marhumin of all of us, may Allah forgive them and grant them Jannat al-Firdaus. May Allah continue to instill the true love of Ahl al-Bayt in our hearts and make it easy for us to educate our youth and to show them the way. And those youth who are hot, some youth are very hot. They can frustrate elders overnight. May Allah soften their hearts and also give us sabr and patience to be able to take them through journey. They don't know that's why. So I leave you with this. Imam Ali says, Al-insan aduwwu ma jahil. Insan is enemy of what he or she is ignorant of. Sometimes somebody may be challenging you, fighting you. Don't worry. Relax. Because he's ignorant of it. So when some of them challenge you, relax, take it easy. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وآله الطاهرين صلى الله على محمد الفاتحة يا علي legend.
السلام عليك يا رسول الله السلام عليك يا أمير المؤمنين السلام عليك يا فاطمة الزهراء سيدتي نساء العالمين السلام عليك يا حسن المجتبى السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك وأناخت برحلك عليكم مني جميعا سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار ولا جعله الله آخر الأحد مني لزيارتكم السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين وعلى أخيك أبو الفضل العباس وأختيك زينب وأم كلثوم وبنتك سكينة السلام عليكم يا أئمة المسلمين علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي السلام عليك يا حجة الله يا ابن الحسن يا صاحب الأمر والعصر والزمان عجل الله تعالى فرجك وسهل الله تعالى مخرجك وظهور الأمر ورحمة الله وبركاته.